conditioned by the primary rupus, and the different combinations condition each visible object to be different.
那么这里的重要性是因为这些四大呢，它支援这个色法，这个色尘升起哦，它是不同比例的四大呢，会有不同的色尘颜色。
So there are conditions for each visible object that is seen now to arise, conditioned by the primary rupas and also arising with other rupas. But at a moment of seeing, which is conditioned by karma and by conditioned by the visible object and the eye sense, only the visible object appears.
那么虽然八不离色里面这个色尘呢有其他色法在一起哦，可是当它所谓撞击眼根的时候呢，只有那个色尘被惊艳了，其他的风火水土，其他的色法是没有被惊艳的。
At another moment, conditioned by karma, also hearing hears sound, and when sound is experienced, the sound also must have arisen in a kalapa with these eight rupas that cannot be, that have to arise in every kalapa, and sound has to be there as well, also conditioned by the same temperature.
那么当比如说现在声音被听到了，那么声音并不在那个最小单位的色聚的八不离色的八个里面哦，所以当声音被听到的时候呢，那个色聚至少有九个，就是八个再加声音。但是同样的，当耳识是因为业的条件让耳识升起去惊艳这个声音的时候，那个只有声音被惊艳到那个色尘，那个最小单位的色聚的其他的色法并不会被惊艳到。
So gradually.We learn about different conditions to understand that the arising of each reality, each visible object, each sound, and the experiencing of a visible object or sound is very intricate, depending on many, many different conditions, nothing to do with an imaginary self at all.
那么这里的重点就是不管是被看到的、被听到的、去看的、去听的，所有这些的因缘条件、各种复杂的条件，他们是非常细致的交织的哦，并不是由一个想象出来的我在那里决定的。
And without the experiencing of countless different rupas arising in different kalapas, and without the memory of what has been experienced through different doorways.There could never be the idea, the fantasy about a chariot.
如果没有刚刚提到的这些复杂的色聚啊，这么多不同的色法，彼此的因缘支柱，各种条件，他们被惊艳的，没有记忆去记住这些各种经验的，那就不会出现马车或者是任何东西的。
And the reason we begin to learn, begin to be familiar with different conditions is to understand that in life, the truth is that there are just different nama dharmas that experience objects and different rupa dharmas that can be experienced and fall away instantly. No chariot, no being, no computer at all.
那么我们在理智上知道这些细节呢，这些复杂的因缘和合的交织呢，是为了能够了解，只是法而已。在日常生活中，只是法，并没有这些所谓的人或想象的东西。
好，非常感谢。我这个明白，天天的明白，因为那个细微的法啊，也是就是它有很多因缘的条件，只是老师是告诉我们，这些它还是因缘和合。它还是没有一个实在的东西，不管哪个层面。
So appreciate and so many different complicated conditions. Just to explain that there is no solid I or anything there.
And the reason we hear about these different conditions and different details is because if we are just told that it's just visible objects seen. or there's just seeing that sees, it's not enough to get rid of the wrong idea that actually there's a forest scene or the people behind Vincent that are seen, for example, or that there is a solid computer. So this is why there has to be more and more considering about the intricate details.
嗯哼，那么更进一步的去思维这些细节啊，这些复杂的因缘关系也是有帮助的。因为如果只是我们如果只是听到被看到的只是色尘，被听到的只是声音，这是不够的，这是不够去慢慢撼动那个对我有东西存在的这个邪见的。
好，谢谢文森，啊，谢谢的，谢谢那个塞巴酱，好像老师过来了。
I'm here now.
你看，丹娜酱。
We were just briefly touching on the conditionalities and the benefit of even just thinking intellectually on the details.
Just to understand the truth of this very moment, is that right?
Whatever
we heard about is to understand the truth of this very moment, is that right? The answer is the understanding of what is now appearing, the answer for any question.
嗯哼，事实上我们要了解的就是这一刻的真相，对不对？所以任何问题的解答其实最后都是回到那现在出现的是什么实相，了解现在出现的实相。
If we start from now on, there can be clear understanding of what we used to think about or question about. Because when there is understanding of this very moment, there can be the understanding of the other moment as well.
嗯哼，所以为什么了解现在出现的法是回答所有的问题的答案呢？因为你了解这一刻的真相，你就可以了解其他的时刻、其他的问题。
And the truth is that we heard just a lot about many, many things. What about the understanding of that which is now appearing?
嗯，我们可以讨论很多很多的主题啊，但是那个现在正在出现的呢？
So it's the moment of developing the understanding, the truth of this moment, which is so very deep.
嗯嗯。所以是建立对现在这一刻真相的了解是如此的深奥的真相。
In order to answer any question.
这样子是可以回答所有的其他的疑问的。
Is there any understanding of that which is now appearing?
现在正在出现的有任何的了解吗？
Only the word is heard, right?
就只是文字上的理解，对不对？
So now, to answer any question, what is seen? Again and again and again, in order to develop the understanding of that which is seen, not just the word.
嗯，所以当我们在问、提问、回答被看到的是什么，一次又一次又一次，是为了要真的了解那个被看到的是什么，而不是只是在文字上知道而已。
Moment of seeing, there's no word about anything at all. But what is true is there to be object of understanding.
在看的那一刻并没有任何的文字哦，但是那个在那里被看到的是要去了解的对象。
Otherwise, we used to think about many, many things all the time.
否则我们就只是一直在想着许多许多不同的事情而已。
So in order to understand the truth of that which is now seeing and that which is seen, it has to be a moment of hearing again about it, to understand it right now.
如果要去了解那个去看的以及那个被看到的，那么就要一直的去听，去听，去思考。
To be truthful to each word. Again, please, what is seen now?
所以我们再来一次，所以被看到的是什么？有没有谁要来跟老师做对答？
被看到的是色法。
What is seen is visible object.
Okay, is there more, a little more understanding of that characteristic which you see? Or just talk about it?
那么对那个被看到的它的特征有没有更多一点点的了解，还是只是在讲着色尘这个文字而已？
The truth is the truth to be truthful to the truth.
真相哦，就是真相，我们只能诚实的、真实的去了解真相。
Dhamma is so very natural because now there's no self. There are different dhammas, but since not understanding it as it is, there is many kind of reality like doubt or thinking about the depth of what is there. But in truth, just ordinary life, beginning from no understanding to have more deep understanding. So what is seen now, see?
Not the word,
not what one has heard, but what is seen now.
法的法现在很自然的就在生灭哦，但是这个法很自然的生灭，会有比如说疑法，或者是邪见，或者是其他的不善法，所以让我们认为有东西或者这个世界是扭曲的。那么我们从没有听过佛陀的教导的这样子的世界里面，逐渐的去了解。真相是什么？
Beginning from the answer. What is seen、
这个、
now?
智慧的培养建立呢，从开始问与答，对佛陀的了解，对佛法的了解。
The natural, the understanding, as much as usual, not from the book or words, what is seen.
那么被看到的是什么呢？是从现在正在发生的去了解，而不是只是文字上而已。
You can ask anyone, and the answer is the truth because of what he thought about that is what he said.、
我们可以问任何一个人、哦、是什么被看到？他说的是真的啊，因为那个是他当时的体验，他的了解就是那样子。对他来讲，那个就是真的。被看到的可能就只是一个人、桌子。
So when there's no thinking about the truth that we have heard, but the truth is that what you see now.
真相被看到的是什么的真相是什么？到底是什么被看到？
我说完一下啊，就是说，就是是不是是就是那个，一切都是因缘和合的东西被看到，或者被看去看的那个也是因缘和合的。
没有错，但是是哪一个法？
是色尘转机眼镜色，所以是才被看到的那个色尘。
So again, what is seen is a visible object that impinges on the eye sense.
Excuse me, that's what you heard, right? But now at this moment, for anyone who hasn't heard, who has heard, no matter much.A little more, a little. What is seen naturally, naturally as usual in daily life.
好，老师说呢，那个是我们听过的答案，对不对？但是老师是说，对于任何人，不管你有听过没有，或者是听过部分的教导，那到底很自然的被看到的是什么？现在到底被看到的是什么？很自然的。
被看到的是东西了已经、
啊、
如果是我们的自然是变成某一样东西了、
Naturally something is seen.
Right, see, from now on we can understand that in a day how many times we do not think about the truth of it at all. Even one has heard a lot, but when time comes, what is seen, see, so naturalIt's something, right? If we don't say anything because no understanding of that, but there is a thing or something is seen, right?
对，的确是这样子。如果没有听过佛陀的教导，很自然的，即使有听过，现在很自然的看到的就是什么东西被看到嘛。所以在一天之中，如果没有去思考过真相是什么， 被看到的一直都是个东西，这个或那个东西被看到而已。
So we learn from what we heard from the teachings of the Buddha. What is seen is so real. It's seen only that. It is that which is seen. Even this word is so short, but it bears all the truth of it. That is seen. What is seen is that which is seen.
但是佛陀告诉我们的真相是什么？被看到的就只是那个被看到的。我们对我们来讲都是东西被看到。佛陀说，就只是那个被看到的。这么短的字，但是包含了真相在里面。
No matter what we use in a day, we see a chariot, we see a flower, we see a bed, but what is seen is only that which is seen and can be seen.
所以在一天之中，不管我们看到的车子、花朵、床布，被看到的就只是那个可以被看到的。
Is that right?
是不是这样子？
But when there's no understanding, we take that for different things. Seeing a chariot, seeing a bed, seeing a door, see? Exactly the same. But that which is seen is only that which can be seen.
因为不知道真相或智慧还没有累积的时候，所以总是认为看到不同的东西，花朵、床布、门都是不同的东西，但事实上就只有那个可以被看到的被看到而已。
And nobody can change the way it is. What is seen is so different, right? Not just only black or white, or just one reality, one quality.
嗯哼，那么被看到的当然也不是只有一种固定都不变的颜色，不是只有黑或者白，还有其他的不同的颜色。
And why they are different? There must be conditions for their difference, because they are different.
那他们为什么是不同的颜色呢？这个色层为什么不一样呢？他们不一样，因为他们有不同的因缘条件。
And what which has been seen, which has seen, fall away, never again to see. Only thinking about it, is that right?With the idea of something is seen.
那么色尘被看到之后呢，它就灭去了。但是去想的这些色尘，想着有什么东西，对不对？
So the intricacy of reality is in the day so much from moment to moment, even in a moment that is there cannot be known at once altogether.
嗯，所以在一天之中呢。有这么多这么多细致交织复杂的因缘条件一直在发生一直在改变灭去、哦、任何一刻的真相就已经是非常深了。
For example, we think that we see and then we touch that we've seen. But actually, that which is seen cannot be touched because it just only be seen, can be seen.
嗯，比如说我们认为我们看到了什么然后我们可以去摸到我们看到的东西。事实上，被看到的并不能被摸到，被看到的就只能被看到，它并不能被摸到。
Can there be touching that which cannot be seen? No, that reality which can be seen, can it be touched?
被看到的，那个可以被看到的，它能被摸到吗？
So usually in a day, there is touching of that which is seen.
对，在我们一天之中呢，我们总是认为我们摸到了我们看到的东西。
Touching the part of chariot and touching the part of the body, is it different?
你去碰一台马车，一台车子，跟去碰自己的身体，有没有什么不同？
And that which is seen,At the chariot and that at the body, is it different?
那么被看到的那个所谓的车子被看到跟身体被看到那个被看到的有什么不同吗？
But what is seen is not that which is touched.
被碰到的并不是那个被看到的。
No matter it is chariot or bed or window or shoes.
管它是车子啊、床铺啊、窗户等等。
This is the beginning to understand what is the absolute truth, as no one and no thing at all, because it has its own characteristic, cannot be changed.
这是开始去了解究竟法的世界是什么，它的本质是特征是不能被改变的。
And no one can make anything arise at all, only conditions for its arising to be such.
那么没有人可以让任何法生起，因缘条件各自的特征。
Can you make a cloth, or can you make a computer, or can you make chariot?
你能够制造电脑、车子吗
？Without absolute truth, can there be anyone who is doing anything?
如果没有法在生灭，会有所谓的人在做出什么东西来吗
？That's right. Learning to understand the absolute truth of no one and no self, they are only different realities, absolute realities.
所以要了解的是这些究竟法，就只是这些法，而并没有任何人跟东西，是因为这些法才有出现人跟东西的概念。
As what the body is composed of is not different from what chariot composed of.
所谓的色身跟所谓的车子都是色法。
The same radio, computer, a car, or machine, anything.
所以我们看到的这些电脑啊、桌子啊，这些所谓不同的东西，其实就是色法。
They are the arising and falling away of that which is conditioned to arise and fall away, but so very, very rapidly that it seems or it looks as no one can experience the arising and falling away of each reality at all, only seeing the succession as nimitta.
非常非常快速哦，每一刻的法的因缘和合，这么多法，这么多复杂的因缘条件，很快速的在。发生，没有人可以很清楚的知道每一个法，那只能去经验它一个接着一个序列的影子而已。
The composition of each reality which arise together are different. That's why at moment of seeing it, it's different color, different shape and form, and so it conditioned the idea of some different things. At moment of seeing, what is seen is exactly this.That which is seen, but that which compose or makes that nimitta arise, the Mahabhuta Rupas, are different. That's why the color, that which is seen, is different. The shape and form is different. The idea of chariot and things are different things.
首先呢，是不同的颜色，当然会出现不同的形状啊，那就会有不同的这个东西或那个东西，车子。那即使是所谓的同一个形状呢，也是因为不同的四大。的组合呢，那个同样的所谓的形状，其实因为不同的四大的组合，那个色层也会看起来不一样。
Even the heat or cold has different level. Everything has so different realities which can appear.
所以有不同的冷热的程度，所以会有各种各种的色法的变化。
So that which is seen is taken for a door or a chariot are different by the composition of that which condition the seeing, the visible object which is seen.
所以这个或那个东西门或什么是因为不同的颜色形成的。
In the absolute truth, is there any chariot?
Is there any, I'm sorry?
Chariot.
Oh, okay. 所以在真正的真相里有马车吗？有车子吗？
Is there the body, my body?
有身体吗？我的身体吗？
Is there I?
有我吗？
So, This is the beginning of understanding a little by little that actually the absolute is citta and cetasika and rupa, no self, no one and no thing. Which is a permanent thing.
就是我们开始去了解只有心心所设法并没有所谓的人或东西有一个存在在那里有一个恒常的存在。
If this truth is not deeply rooted, how can there be more understanding of that which is now appearing?
如果对这个真相上的理智上的了解不能够越来越深根深蒂固那怎么去真的有条件经验法
No matter it is different moment, different shape and form, and different idea, but the truth is that what is seen is only that which can be seen, no matter what is there, at the body or at the pillow.
不管任何时刻被看到什么东西，就只是那个可以被看到的被看到，不管是所谓的桌子或枕头。
Any moment of touching,Any moment of seeing, no matter where in this world or other world, the truth has to be the truth, the absolute truth.
嗯，对，任何时刻，不管被碰到的是什么，被看到的是什么，不管在人间或在任何一切啊，被碰到的、被看到的，永远就是那些法而已，它对应的法。
What is the truth now at moment of touching?What is the truth at moment of seeing? See, no one there at all. It's gone. They are all gone faster than we can imagine.
在碰到的那一刻的真相是什么？在看的那一刻的真相是什么？并没有人在那里哦，立刻就灭去，立刻就灭去。
What about a moment ago seeing, a moment ago hearing? Where are they now?
那刚才的去看的去听的现在在哪里
So where is the chariot right now?
所以车子现在在哪里
The scene that we take for seeing a chariot is gone completely. So no chariot.
那个我们认为是车子的那个被看到的已经早就灭了那个车子在哪里
At moment of touching any part of the bodyHardness appears, but then after that, gone.
我们碰触身体的时候呢，或许碰触到硬，就在那一刻硬被惊艳了，然后那个元素色法就灭了。
So what is I and where am I? Nothing, nowhere at all, because everything is gone.
所以什么是我？我在哪里？每一刻就这样，什么都过去了。
So no matter what we take for chariot, shoes, house, are they not the same in the absolute sense, absolute reality?
所以我们看到的不管是鞋子啊或任何的所有的东西他们在究竟法里没有不是都一样吗
If there is no more and more understanding of the truth, there cannot be any moment ofLetting go of that which is so very deeply rooted as something all the time.
如果不能够真正的了解，不能够真正的有信心，那又怎么可能逐渐的放掉？对，深深认为有个东西在那里，然后去执取呢
？So what is the point of studying to understand each word about the truth of each reality right now? Otherwise, it cannot.Be the object of understanding at moment when it's appearing right now.
所以我们研读佛法的目的呢，就是了解每个法到底是什么。
And just one word or one part or one aspect is not enough at all, because so many, many or so much ignorance about whatever is now appearing from moment to moment.
如果只是讨论某一个法，或者是只是讨论某一个单纯的角度是不够的，因为我们累积的这些无明啊、邪见太深了。
So the object of studying or hearing, listening, is to understand the truth of it little by little, only one at a time, clearer and clearer.
所以我们要去了解的对象呢，就是现在正在出现的法，一点一点的越来越清楚。
Is there any question?
有没有问题呢？
So much to develop understanding the truth of what is there now.
有那么多那么长的一段路要去了解、啊、培养正道了解智、培养智慧。
This is the beginning to understand that no matter how much we learn about the word and the truth of it, but it's not the moment of understanding the truth yet.、
嗯、所以我们要先能够区别，我们知道很多是只是知道文字而已，还是我们真的开始知道现在正在出现的法。
And to understand the truth is the moment when there is understanding the characteristic of that which is now appearing with direct awareness. Because it's there, like hardness now is there. Is there any moment of understanding, developing understanding, or beginning to be aware?
嗯，就好像现在印就在这里已经出现了。但是有任何的直接上的了解，能够真的是去觉知它吗？
The truth of that is the moment when it's the object of awareness. Because there is touching all there, but no word, no understanding at all. So how can there be conditioned moment to be aware of that with understanding?
我们整天都在所谓的碰触之中、哦、这个或那个、哦、但是有任何的了解那个或觉知到被碰触的其实并不是什么东西吗？只是一个法吗？
This is a moment of understanding how subtle the teaching of the Buddha is about realities because realities are so very subtle. It arises but it appears as it doesn't arise and fall away at all.
佛陀传的法，传法这个法是非常深奥的，它其实一直都在，但是它并没有被知道。
Each reality is the same, its condition to arise and fall away, depending on whether it is that which experiences or that which cannot experience.
嗯，所以法一直都在生灭哦，然后经验一直都在发生，那个可以去经验的，一直在经验那个。某个对象。
So it's not just only seeing which is appearing now. The other reality like hardness is also appearing, not at the same moment, but it seems like they are together.
那么不是现在不是只有在看而已哦，也是有在碰触，对不对？但是这是在不同的时刻。
And that cannot be clear understanding of any reality yet as they appear together. Because they appear together, so how can there be more understanding of each one as it is different?
因为很快、哦、好像几乎都一直在出现，好像这经验几乎是可以同时看到跟听到跟摸到跟在想。那这些全部都混在一起，又怎么能够开始一个一个去了解呢？
So learn to understand the truth of what is there now, that they arise and fall away so very, very rapidly, that they can be the idea of something is seen by nimitta.、
嗯、那么也因为这些快速的生灭、哦、快速的经验，那有一个整体的整体的一个概念在那里、哦、那一个一个去了解其实是去了解他们留下的影子，在任何一刻他们这么多在生灭是不可能去知道的，是之后他们留下的影子可以一个一个被了解。
And this is what Buddha said after his enlightenment. Dharma is so very very deep, very very subtle, very very difficult to experience、
嗯、所以佛陀在他开悟成佛的时候呢，他了解了这个法是如此的深奥，这么难的去懂。
And from understanding the words of the truth, one begins to understand the Buddha, the virtues of the Buddha, and who's the Buddha, the enlightened truth is so very difficult to penetrate.
那么也只有透过了解佛陀所教导的真相，透过因为对真相的了解，才能够真的开始了解佛陀是谁。
When there is no understanding of the subtlety of reality right now, can anyone say that I know Buddha? I respect him.
如果不能够了解佛陀的教导的真相的深奥，那谁可以说他了解佛陀？
This is to be truthful, Satya, from the very beginning.
这是从一开始就要有的很诚实哦，真诚真实。
To respect the enlightened one, but to what? Respect what? See, with our understanding, it's just the word.
所以，当我们说尊敬佛陀，尊敬什么？尊敬佛陀的什么？如果没有智慧了解，那我们到底在尊敬什么
？So the deep respect.Develop from understanding what is there now. And when there's more understanding, more respect to the truth, to the enlightenment, who shows the truth.
所以那个深深的尊敬，对佛陀深深的尊敬是来自于对真相，对他的教导的更深的了解。
So anyone who does notTruth of what he said at all, can it be respect to him?
所以那些如果不能够真的了解他在说什么的人，他怎么真心的去尊敬他呢？
So it's not the word, but it's the truth of whatever is there, each moment, conditioned to arise and then fall away, never to return.
所以不是只有文，不能只是停在文字的阶段而已。那个现在在那里的是什么？它的有因缘条件的生灭这么快，在那里到底是什么
？Until the truth of each reality appear to the moment of right understanding of that as it is. Otherwise, it's just talking about it. But what about the arising and falling away of whatever is now appearing?
所以直到这些正在出现生命的法，它出现在智慧，智慧可以去经验了解它，在那之前都是在文字上的讨论而已。
And when there is the understanding clear about one word from one to one, there can be the understand what Buddha said about the chariot or anything in the Sutta and Vinaya and Abhidhamma.
那么真正的了解真正的经验法之后呢，就能够真正的读懂佛陀在经典里面讲到的马车或人或什么，他用的传统语言才能够真正的被了解。
So each word of the Buddha's teaching will condition moment of letting go, that which is ignorance and attachment and all akusala dhamma.
真的了解佛陀的话呢，它会是成为舍离。这些累积很深的无明邪见，这些不善的一个因缘条件。
Until ignorance of all dharmas are completely eradicated to be arahata, no more kilesa, no more kusala, no more akusala。
一直到对法的无知无明被根除了，那就成为阿罗汉。
If we haven't heard the teachings of the Buddha at all.We cannot understand how much ignorance is there from moment to moment in life.
如果我们从来没有听过佛陀的教导，我们没有办法真的知道我们现在到底有多深的无明，一刻接着一刻，一世接着一世。
That's why study each word about each reality carefully to understand the truth of it.
所以我们是很小心谨慎的去了解佛陀的教导的每个字的。
Without the four primary rupas, can there be anything which can be seen?
如果没有四大，那么会出现那个可以被看到的吗？
Without the four primary rupas, can there be smell? To be smelled?
如果没有四大，会有气味被闻到吗？
And even there are rupa and citta and cittasika, it depends on conditions too, to condition the moment of seeing or hearing or experiencing anything to arise, not at will.
那么即使有各种明法或设法的生灭、哦、那也是各自的不同的因缘条件才会有这一刻是去听还是去看还是在想。
When there is the understanding of that which is seen, can there be less doubt about chariot and table and thing?
如果能够有更多一点点的了解那个被看到的到底是什么，那么会不会有更少的怀疑到底什么是车子或者是任何东西。
At moment of experiencing hardness, they cannot be seeing. See, this is the truth. But now it doesn't appear like that.
在碰触的那一刻呢，被碰到的其实并不是被看到的，但是这个还没有被了解。我们以为我们是碰到我们看到的。
So how subtle this moment is that at moment of seeing, there cannot be anything else appearing at all. No sound.No smell.
在看到的那一刻呢，只有那个被看到的，不会有被听到的，不会有被闻到的。
But at moment of smelling, there are so many things around too. Is that right? Because of the rapidity of reality, no one can change its way. But right understanding can begin to understand the difference reality at different moment.
但是由于生灭太快了，所以比如说在闻的那一刻，闻到的那一刻，好像也同时有好多事情正在发生。那么只有正确的了解，才能够逐一的去看到真相。
Otherwise, the idea of self is there in each moment, from moment to moment. Moment of seeing, moment of touching, moment of smelling, moment of thinking about that which is experienced.To be something.
如果不能够了解这一刻的真相呢，那么就一定会有我存在的概念哦，有一个我在那里经验，在那里闻，在那里听，在那里看。事实上，每一刻、每一刻、每一刻都并没有我的存在。
Is this not subtle? Subtle? Is this not profound? So very deep to understand the truth. But the truth is the truth, absolute truth.
那么这样子深奥吗？这样子不精细吗？
那我听老师这么解释了，连这个尊敬，尊敬也是智慧，所以我们现在认为我们尊敬佛陀，其实也还不是算上真正的尊敬吗？这个是我的问题。
Okay. The question is about respecting Buddha, the Buddha. So, respecting is also wisdom. So even though we think we respect the Buddha, it doesn't really mean we have the wisdom yet to respect the Buddha, truly, sincerely respecting Buddha.
Do you respect goodness too? Wholesomeness?
那你会尊敬善吗？
会。
Yes.
See, so it depends on kusala moment, which is conditioned to arise to respect what? Parents, the benefactor, or whatever.
所以你也是因缘条件升起尊敬哦，你也可以尊敬父母亲啊，感恩他们。
And who respect unwholesomeness?
那么谁尊敬不善。
But in all realities, the wholesome realities, Panya is the best of all wholesome reality.
我们尊敬善哦，那善里面最好的就是智慧，所以尊敬智慧。
That's why we respect parents and we respect Buddha higher than that, any respect at all.
那从这个角度来讲， 佛陀的智慧，尊敬智慧，那最高的智慧，所以佛陀在一切之上。
Just like give birth to understanding of each reality in any life, each life, but parents only in this life.
那么我们的父母亲当然是值得尊敬的，他给了我们所谓的这一世的生命，但佛陀给了我们真相是什么？不只是这一世而已。
Does anyone respect someone better than respecting Buddha?
有谁尊敬某个人超过佛陀呢？
实际上是应该没有，可是大多数的人啊，好像我也可以，如果真的没有学 佛法的时候啊，我们当然是尊敬我们的家长，对我们有恩的人，然后那个尊敬啊，不管是对也好错也好，我们也是讲得比较白的，就是好像是盲目的尊敬这样子咯。
嗯哼，
所以如果真的没有了解法的话，我们认为我们的尊敬是真的尊敬吗？
你要不要直接跟老师讲泰文？
不要啦，
不要好了。OK，
可以慢慢想。其实
好，well, for someone who never heard of the teachings, they could respect any person, and or even when we say we respect the Buddha, it could be blind respect.So, without based on the true understanding, without the real understanding of the truth, there can be no real respect to the Buddha.
So, just say, I respect the Buddha and pay homage to him. Is that the manner of true respect? When there is the understanding, it's different.
所以的确哦，如果只是说、哦、我尊敬佛陀，只是去那边顶礼，这不一定是真正的尊敬佛陀，要看智慧的各个阶段。
And we can say that at moment of understanding, no matter when, that is moment of respecting the Buddha, respecting the truth that which hasn't been heard before or understood before at all.
那么智慧升起的时候呢，那一刻我们也可以说，那一刻是在尊敬佛陀，那一刻是在累积对真相的了解。
And the best way to pay respect is the moment of understanding, because at that very moment, who conditions such understanding?
那么我们也可以说，在了解真相的那一刻，就是在礼敬佛陀。是谁给的？是什么样的因缘条件才能够有这个智慧去了解真相
？So anytime when there's good deeds, it's conditioned from understanding and how come without the understanding of the words of the teaching about the truth, there's no condition for such and more wholesome moments, and with understanding too sometimes.By conditions.
那么在善的那一刻呢、如果不是有一个很深的智慧成为他的善升起的因缘条件，善又怎么能够升起呢？那善升起的时候，偶尔是会有智慧伴随的。
To be more friendly and to have more compassion, how come? When there's understanding, and when there's more understanding, and when there's no understanding.Much different.
那么为什么会对别人友善呢？为什么会对别人悲悯呢？怎么来的？那当然，不同的智慧的阶段会不同。
And Pal, it's the same also when we read about or people talk about taking refuge in the Buddha. It's the same. It's paying respect to the qualities of the Buddha.Through the development of understanding.
我们讲的皈依佛也是这个意思哦。 也是因为你对真相的了解的深度，你皈依佛的程度，你礼敬佛的程度，你依靠他的程度也会不同。
For example, when we read about the 40 objects of samatha or calmness that are developed, such as metta and so on, but without understanding the truth about realities, without understanding the Buddha's teachings, there can never be any Buddhanusati taking refuge in the Buddha or Dhammanusati taking refuge in the Dhamma, because without understanding about Dhammas, now, as anatta, there cannot be the appreciation of the Buddha's qualities.
那么当我们提到那个四十业处的时候呢，同样的，关于佛随念或者是法随念，如果对现在这一刻的法并没有真正的去了解，那么又怎么会感念感激佛陀的教导呢？又怎么会很自然的有所谓的佛随念跟法随念呢？
So respecting the Buddha or taking refuge in the Buddha doesn't depend on the physical circumstances. It doesn't depend on whether one's inside or outside the temple. It doesn't depend on what one's bodily posture is, because these are just manifestations. It's the understanding of the Dhamma, the understanding of the qualities of the Buddha thatis the paying of respect or taking refuge in the Buddha.
所以礼敬佛陀、依靠佛陀、皈依佛，它是一个心理的状态啊。它跟我们的是否在庙宇之中、在佛寺之中，或者是我们身体的姿势是没有关系的。
So it's only through the development of understanding.deeper and deeper until it's clearer and clearer that there can really be the development of respect and taking refuge in the Buddha, the Dhamma and the Sangha.
那么也只有随着智慧的累积建立，对真相的更深更进一步的了解，才有所谓真正的皈依三宝，真正的以他们为依靠。
Without any understanding of the truth now, it's quite meaningless to say, oh yes, every night I take refuge in the triple chair or I go to the temple to show respect, because it's just thinking about words or clinging to the idea of taking refuge or showing respect, but not the understanding of the truths that the Buddha taught at this moment.
如果没有真的了解现在这一刻的真相，那么即使是每天晚上礼敬佛，或者是到庙里面、寺庙里面去顶礼，这是没有真正的意义的。那没有真正的了解这一刻的真相，这些都可能成为执取的对象，其实只是执取我在皈依佛，或者是我在礼敬佛这件事情。
And in truth,Just like there is no Pal, no Sarah now, and there never was a Pal or a Sarah. In truth, there never was a Buddha, a person, a being, but there were the qualities, the great wisdom, the great compassion, the great metta, those qualities that were developed and were enlightened to the truths of the world. So it's the qualities, the...enlightened wisdom that we pay respect to.
那么真相是呢，没有小伴，没有 Sarah， 没有佛陀，那有的只是法。那么所谓的佛陀，是我们礼敬的是他的智慧以及悲悯慈爱，他的智慧呢，把真相给显现出来了。
And it's the same when we think of our associates or friends or teachers. It's respect to the goodness and the good qualities and the encouragement in kusala and understanding that we show respect.
对，当我们所谓的跟善知识在一起，我们也是一样哦，我们尊敬的是他的善， 那么他鼓励我们去了解真相是什么。
And this is a way that more understanding, more respect is developed with less clinging little by little to the idea of someone or something, a chariot or a person or a great being. Just appreciating more and more about what is really worthy of respect and what is not worthy of respect at all.
嗯，那么也只有透过对这一刻的真相的一点一点的了解，那么才能够真正的知道什么是值得尊敬的，什么其实是不值得尊敬的。
Otherwise, we just go on thinking more and more about stories about chariots or Buddhas or people or temples, but forget about just the understanding of the truth at this moment, that it's just that which is visible that's seen now. No one there, no thing there at all. Just sound that's heard now, the world at this moment. Nothing else, no other world.Just the sound and then gone instantly. So gradually getting closer and closer to the truth of life at this moment is a way that respect develops greater and greater to the qualities of the Buddha.
所以也只有透过逐渐的进一步的了解现在这一刻的真相是什么，才是真正的去尊敬礼敬佛。否则我们就是一直在各种故事里，在车子，在人，在什么东西的这个世界的故事里面哦，所以也只有透过了解被看到的是什么，声音是什么，每一刻每一刻那一刻的真相是什么。
所以不管我们做什么都是了解为主，要了解哦。好的，谢谢。
So the key is understanding.
And it's such a relief, really, because no need to be in another place, no need to be following the same actions as one's friends, no need to be in the holy sites right now, no need to be anywhere doing anything, because at this very moment, there can be understanding of the truth from hearing and wise considering, and life is just at this very moment.So the respect has to be right now with understanding.
所以这样子的了解也是一种放松哦，一个释放哦，没有一个压力一定要去追随某一种仪式，或者是一定要跟随谁的行为才是对的。任何一刻在任何地方都可以是尊敬佛陀，都可以是了解那一刻的真相哦，没有说你一定非得怎么样不可。
We may be on our death bed or very sick like Nakula Pita in the sutta that was mentioned last time, unable to move, unable to go anywhere. But even at those moments in great pain, there can be pain respect, there can be understanding of the truth, always back to this moment, no matter the circumstances.
Mm-hmm.就像上个星期我们提到的所谓的身体的病痛哦，那位老者先生他身体是痛苦的，生病的，那我们在病床上即将死亡的时候，或许有非常非常多的痛，但是那一刻也可以是了解真相，那一刻也可以是尊敬佛陀的。那张
Yes、
Would you like to say or conclude?
Is there any question? The truth is this very moment andThere can be the understanding to be truthful, how much understanding of this moment is. So we don't underestimate the truth that is so very difficult, so very subtle. That's why it takes quite a long time to let go. Only when there is more and more understanding. Just hearing the word, it begins to understand the word about the truth.Of reality right now, but it's not time yet to directly understand it as we have heard. But after that, when there is more understanding, more respect, the best moment in life, no matter what life, this life, other life. The best moment is understanding the truth. Otherwise, it's so blind. No one knows the truth about this moment at all.
嗯哼，那么这里有两个重点哦。第一个是关于真相就在这一刻，如此的但是我们对这一刻的了解有多深，我们也要很诚实哦。有不同的程度，也可以诚实知道这个真相是很深奥的，不是我们很快就可以了解的。那第二件事情就是一世接着一世，最珍贵的就是智慧，了解真相的智慧。否则我们一直在黑暗之中是瞎子，是看不到真相，不知道什么才是真的。
Only when there's the understanding of the self, it can let go, not to try so much that I want to experience it, want to let go, and that is wrong.
那么我们了解真相这件事情呢，它会成为我们一种自由。我们没有说我一定要做什么，并没有一个我的存在必须要做什么事情，也由不得由我来做什么事情。这是一种真自由的释放。
So listen with understanding that nothing can arise without conditions. That's why depending on when it arises by conditions, not by me, try so hard. That is the right path.
正确的道路并不是由我很努力的试着要做什么，每一刻都是因缘和合的。这个是没有谁的存在可以用意志力做什么，这是正确的道路。
When there's more letting go and understanding that no one can make anything arise, that is the real, the true conditions for the arising of understanding directly of what is now appearing.
那么这样子的对真相的了解呢，才会对我的存在的执取逐渐放掉，那么也会是智慧升起的因缘条件呢。
So there can be understanding of conditions for next moment when we finish the talk, right? Instantly, even right now.
那所以即使是我们结束佛法讨论，也可能有因缘条件，有智慧升起。
And at moment of picking the book up to read or to consider or to turn on the radio or whatever, to consider the truth.By conditions, that is the only way to let go the idea of self, little by little.
所以当我们拿取一本佛法的书经典来读，或者是打开这个佛法讨论的录音来听，都是因缘条件，一切都是因缘条件，这件事情是智慧能够培养的因缘条件。
So the truth of understanding is to understand that anatta, no one there at all, even this moment, very moment, is conditioned.
智慧的真相就是去了解，并没有我。现在这一刻就是这样子，并没有我。